NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 52 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. So we're going to start taking a look now at this ability to roll, add a method to roll ability scores story that we have for our 0.3 milestone. So I've modified this a bit. Before it just had roll ability scores returning an array of integers. I want to have this essentially parallel the interface of what we have with total dice and roll dice, where total will give you an array of integers, roll will give you an array of dice set objects, so that, again, thinking about if somebody were wanting to do this and represent it in HTML or something like that, you'd know out of the, let's say you're rolling 4d6, keeping the highest 3, you want to know what that fourth die is, and just giving the integers won't give you that information. So that's kind of what we're looking at in this next set of few videos as we'll be implementing this. The first thing we're going to do is take a look at the options for this and add them to our configuration object. By default, I want to be able to do something like this with no options specified and get what's configured in the NerdDice configuration class. So we'll start there, look what we've got so far. So right now we have ability score array size. It is an attribute accessor, and it gets set to a default of 6 in the initialize method. So we're gonna, similar to how we, if we look at dice set, let's keep configuration around, but if we look at dice set, we had the bonus method. Bonus equals is somewhere here. There it is. So bonus equals new value. Try to do the value to an integer. And if it fails to do that, then it will raise an argument error. So I think we're going to, for all of these attributes in the, that are going to pertain to the rollability scores setup, we're going to want them to have a similar type of interface where it allows for duck typing, it tries to convert it to an integer, and then if it fails, it it raises an argument error. And then there are going to be a few other validations we'll need to do. For example, you've got to have your number of dice to keep has to be fewer than your, less than or equal to the number of dice that you're rolling, and all of these have to be positive integers greater than 0. So we'll start getting to work on that by modifying our existing configuration spec. So right now, we have, it has an ability score array size of 6. And then I'm going to, we'll keep that around, but we'll add a block describe conditions and error handling and then we'll also have a describe, we'll call it duck type integer So as it relates to the ability score array, let me pause and write the it statements here. So we've got our it statements here. Let's start implementing them. So this should still, oh, hold on, let me do a specific item with a string item as well. So I added a second it statement there allowing you to provide a numeric string. So this will be similar to what we did with the foreground color. That one should pass right away because that's the existing functionality. And this one should fail. Try that run just on our configuration. So as expected, one failed, one passed. And we'll continue on and write our failing specs for the rest of this. So I've got the first one written here where just letting the error message be the expected error message that we've got, and then asserting that the attempt to set this to threve will raise an argument error with the error message. Do the same thing for the other negative testing cases. So I've got the specs written. We'll take a look at, save the specs, take a look at what we've got so far. We've got a bunch of failures. So in a lot of these, nothing was raised because it's not doing any sort of a validation for you. So let's see how RuboCop is. Both correctable. Still failing. We are. All right, let's try to implement this and make it pass. Go into configuration. So instead of attribute accessor, this will now be an attribute writer because, or reader, not a writer. It'll be a reader because my writer will now need to be a. Method here. Did this for bonus. So this will, let's not make that a class instance, or a class variable. Exact expected error message here. Put it between quotes. This will make some of them pass, I believe. Got more failures than we used to have. New value, okay. So I got to use the same arguments in both places. All right, now we're down to 3. So our failing cases are 11 billion is not raising an error because that will go to 0 when you call 2i on it, 0 and negative 6. So that's what we want. New value is greater than 0. Now we're back to all passing. We'll run the whole suite. Whole suite is passing. Code coverage looks good. All right, so I'm going to go and take a look at the other items there. So the other items we need are a number of sides, number of dice rolled, number of dice kept. So I'll write some specs for these. They're going to be very repetitive, so we're gonna want to use something resembling a shared example for these eventually, but we'll at least get the basic idea of these in place, and then we can look at refactoring. So I've got the first one of these, ability score dice rolled. So it'll have a default of 4. It will allow you to set a new quantity of dice rolled. And then an error situation. Got it like that. These should all fail. They do. Let's implement this. So got the reader dice rolled. We set the default. That should reduce some of the number of failures. Yep, got rid of the top one. Now we'll move at this. Should give us what we need. It does. Move on to the next attribute, which is number of sides. We'll follow a similar pattern here. So similar process for number of sides, which should all fail. They do. I'm gonna move this up, make it before the dice rolled. Because I want dice rolled and dice kept to stay close to each other. Hopefully still failing. It is. Implement it. Thank you. here. I didn't rescue the no method error. Working, and then we'll take care of the last one, which is number of dice kept. Yes. So make those changes. So I've got the blocks now for the dice ability score, dice kept. They're all failing. So by default, this will be 3. Let's implement this. And this line is getting too long. It's going to get wrapped when RuboCop fusses at us. Down to 6 failures. It does. Now we'll implement the method. Rescue. All right, we're still 100% covered. There is one more thing we need to validate, and that's that the ability score number of dice rolled is not less than the ability score dice kept. So I think when setting dice kept, we're going to raise an error saying it can't be more than ability score dice rolled. But on the opposite side, you don't want to create a catch-22 where it's impossible to do this. So on the ability score dice rolled side, we're going to, if the dice kept is greater than the number of dice rolled, then we'll wind up setting that dice kept value to match dice rolled. And put a new line before private. So let's go to our configuration. Kept it. Finish typing this. So here's our new validation. It can't set the ability score higher than ability score dice rolled, and it'll raise a nerd dice error rather than an argument error. So this will fail because nothing will be raised. And let's go in and implement it. Duck type error message and our compare error message. Passing with the whole suite, and then the final item there is that we will set the so we'll have two here. Side it set lower. This will also change play score dice kept to 2. So one of these will fail and one of these will pass right now. And then we're going to go to dice rolled here. guess then. Ability score dice kept. Going to want to warn. And write the message. So this is how I wrote it. I warning ability score rolled set to a lower value than ability dice kept when reducing it from old value to new value. So we'll see how that goes. It did it, and it did warn. Is good. And we have some refactoring to do, but we're getting on in terms of the time in this particular episode, so I'm going to commit what we've got, and then we'll have an item in our backlog to refactor the configuration spec and configuration object. So to finish up here, see how RuboCop is upset. Let's take a look here. So 11 out of the 12 are auto-correctable. Most of them are wanting dot positive rather than greater than zero. I don't see a problem with that. We'll try auto-correcting. See how, unless new value positive, that's all fine. Take a look at what our violations are now. Down to one, which is metrics method length, which I might be able to woodenly fix by just deleting the empty line. Add an empty line after the guard clause. All right. Autocorrect that. We're back to the method length line. I think for now we will add that into our ignore here, and we'll fix it when we refactor. So I think I've got one of these in NerdDice. So no offenses. We will check out a new branch for this. So check out roll ability scores. commit. Write our message. So I've got my commit message. We'll sign it and push to our new branch. Check on the GitHub actions. And we passed here. Let's go back to our project. So we're going to add a new item. Add that, move this to done, and we'll pick up with refactoring in the next episode.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.